All right, here we are, game two, semifinal between Cupertino High School and University School Sharks in the High School Star League Winter Season 2016 playoffs. We get right on into this draft. Cupertino, they are up 1-0 in this best of three. And we take a look at the bands they've picked. It is Ricky, Timbersaw, Juggernaut, Alchemist, and they've picked up Storm again, as well as that Slardar. For the side of University School Sharks, they've banned out the Shadow Demon, Venomancer, Bounty Hunter, and Darkseer. They themselves have picked up Ogre Magi, Legion Commander, and now the Silencer. So we can only assume that Storm Spirit will be played again by Sane, and Slardar played by Effie. They've now picked up the Omni Knight, which is a huge counter to Legion Commander. But what they're looking for on the side of University School Sharks is a Silence Ogre Magi with the Bloodlust onto the Legion Commander and trying to get as much dual damage as they can. It's going to be kind of difficult for University School Sharks to find this, considering the fact that they are going to have Repel on the side of Cupertino. But we'll have to see what they do for the rest of this draft. So, Silencer, Legion Commander, Ogre Magi. Oops. We'll have to see if Ogre Magi and Silencer are both the supports. We'll have a better understanding of that with kind of the next pick. For the side of Cupertino, Slardar could be in that support role again with Omni Knight and Storm in the mid lane once again. So they could still need their safe laner and their off laner, which could be a Drow. Make Storm that much stronger. Drow in the safe lane, off lane could be a ranged hero too. And that would put USS in a bit of trouble in the early game as well as the late game if Zane has another game like he did in game one. So USS, they're looking for something to go along with this Silencer, Legion Commander, Ogre Magi. And they choose to go with the Anti-Mage, and here comes the Sven from Cupertino. Anti-Mage, Silencer, Legion Commander, Ogre Magi, gonna be pretty solid for Anti-Mage to drain that mana from the side of Cupertino, but Repel is gonna make it difficult for Anti-Mage if he does get chased down. Repel on a Sven, 10 seconds to go. God Strength, Storm Hammer, that could be it from an Anti-Mage. Magnus gonna get banned out by University School Sharks, OD by Cupertino. Offlane Legion, safe lane Anti-Mage, safe lane Sven, mid Storm Spirit, possibly an offlane hero coming up from Cupertino if they don't choose to go with that Slardar support again. Reserve time. Last pick, it's not going to be that Darkseer, could be Batrider. Wouldn't be a horrible pick. Lasso on any of these heroes on University School Sharks would be an issue. Lasso, Slithering Crush, Electric Vortex, Storm Hammer, just a lot of lockdown if they do pick up that Batrider. For side of USS, they've got the Fire Blast, they've got the Duel, but right now that's about it. So they still need a mid laner, preferably someone with a stun. Maybe Windrunner. Could be Silencer from the back end. Beastmaster does the same thing. Sort of like Batrider, you have that Primal Roar, get that stun up, you can try and chain your stuns. And it is a lot of lockdown to possibly counter this Anti-Mage. So, USS, see what they go with.
5 seconds.
Reserve time.
And it will be the Invoker, which is pretty solid. Tornado is a bit more of the lockdown. Maybe they can use that Sunstrike with the Legion Commander. So you've got Lissuna on the Beastmaster, Meme Shard Sven, Nickel Pickle, Omni Knight, Zane, Storm Spirit, Zaturk on the Invoker, Alfredo, Anti-Mage, Kataro Legion Commander, Chance on the Ogre Magi, Conkle on the Silencer, and that leaves Effie on the Slardar. So we'll be ready to load in, hopefully not disconnect. As Effie finally picks up that Slardar, and Conkle soon to pick up that Silencer.
10 seconds to go.
Switch it over. We get ourselves no disconnect. Does Cupertino need a moment?
What's with all the scribbling?
So, we are ready to go. Conkle is on that silencer. And it looks as though all five of Cupertino will go top. Maybe they do find themselves Legion Commander. It would be a pretty solid start as the other four of University School Sharks are going the other way. So they wait. They smoke. And they could find Kataro. Doesn't know he's running into the entire side of Cupertino. And this can definitely feel... be really bad for University School Sharks. Cupertino now spots Kataro. There's the Stormhammer. Not enough just yet. They place the Deep Ward. Kataro trying to run away. Now Meme Shard goes the other direction. And Kataro, he does... not have a TP. So this will be first blood one way or another. Just going to eat those tower pot shots. Maybe try and come around and deny himself to neutrals. He's denying the first blood, but it's 269 gold. Split the way of Sven, Storm Spirit, and Omni Knight. So first kill goes the way of Cupertino. They're up 1-0 in this best of three. They're looking to finish it off, make their way to the grand finals. Zane picks up the Bounty Rune. And he has himself an assist. He's got himself a quick lead. So we take a look at these lanes. Zaturk mid with the Invoker. Mid for the side of Cupertino is Zane on the Storm Spirit. Up top, we do see Lissuna jungling as Slardar Effie makes his way to the offlane. And Meme Shard is going to be up top with this Sven and Nickel Pickle supporting him. The offlane, like we saw earlier, Kataro will be here with the Legion Commander, Invoker mid, and then down low, we will see Chance as well as Conkle and Alfredo. So the Ignite already out on Effie. Effie probably going to have to go for that Iron Talon, back off and try and get his farm in the side camp, and maybe make his way into lane every now and then while Lissuna is jungling. And for the side of Cupertino, there could be some possibility for some kills here up top. Meme Shard, Stormhammer with the Purification once he gets it on Nickel Pickle. Kataro already level 2. So has overwhelming odds. So Effie not finding anything. Conkle will be here with Chance. Just trying to push away Effie. He'll wait for that Iron Talon, which is the life of an offlaner. Meme Shard is still up top against Katara, and then we took a look over at Zane up against Zeturk. It looks as though Zane's having an easier time. He's up 1 CS, now down 2 CS. But Zane, once he's level 6, Zeturk's definitely going to have to watch out. It's going to be a hard lane for him, especially if a gank comes through, but I really doubt it. Although Effie did make his way over to the mid lane a couple times last game, and we may see it again this time around. Invisibility. Take a look up top, Kitaru. At about 2/3 health, and Nickel Pickle gets the block, but not really much coming off of it as the creep wave is here. So Zane just gonna sit mid with the Invis rune, soak up some experience, and really not trying to get into the way of Zeturk. Let the creep wave push, find some gold, find some levels, and eventually go in on this invoker. Lissuna, on the other hand, has that Iron Talon, boots, and a salve for this jungling time. Let's see if he just denies himself to neutrals or backs off. Has Born another second. Ooh. Boy, Iron Talon, one more shot. Lissuna! He will go down to the neutral creep. But he did buy out, so no harm. So Effie actually elects to go just boots. It's an interesting call from this Swarder. Not too sure why he didn't go for the Iron Talon. Can at least clean up these creeps, find yourself a little bit of gold, but not choosing to do so. We take a look over mid. Zane is level 5, not close to level 6 just yet. Zeturk is closer than he is at about halfway there, so we'll see if level 6 maybe Zane makes his way up top as we take a look as Kitaru level 4 and off on this side cam. Oh, boots come out for Zane. Pretty calm early game this time around. And Zane continuing to grab himself some farm, still looking for that level 6. Zeturk is just about there. And should probably get it with this creep wave. So we take a look over. Beastmaster level 4, no level 6 for the Primal Roar just yet. Zane missing that catapult. And really just trying to harass out Zeturk, but it's not doing too much. Still has those Forge Spirits just to kind of push this wave and make it a hard time for Zane. So Last Word comes in on Effie. Slithering Crushed used by Effie. Last Word hits Sunstrike off the mark. Purification from Nickel Pickle. And just a break in the engagement, really not much happening. So Meme Shard with this stack will find a bit more farm, has 800 gold, looking for that early Helm of the Dominator. Stack up this ancient camp and find himself some farm later on. That should be good for him as the game has been kind of quiet. He should be able to get it quite easily. Zane not level 6, Invoker is. We'll see if maybe someone makes a rotation to come in on Zane before he's level 6, but I really doubt that happening, as he has now made it to level 6. So now Zane can kind of zip forward. He's really trying to put the pressure on Zeturk, but it's not going to be there. It's not going to be easy until he's got someone like the Beastmaster Lissuna with the Primal Roar. We take a look down low. We haven't taken a look at Alfredo yet. Now, Fredo's got himself those treads, 40 and 16 behind the Sven, and he's had himself some easy free farm. Meanwhile, mid, as we take our eyes off it for a split second, Zane finds himself a kill on the Invoker. Like I said, he would at level 6. So 2-0 for Cupertino, who I've been told topped out Group B. They're not actually 6 seeded, it's just how they made Group A play Group B. And according to chat, might be the better team. So the dog story, we could keep that, you know, plot line if we do want to. Should be okay. Now, Asuna with level 6, I wouldn't be surprised if he makes his first gank up top, try and kill Kataru. Or maybe even mid again. That wouldn't be too bad. And we do see it, because Effie's made his way mid. There's the TP forwards at Turk. He's got to back off now. Asuna going to get in with that Primal Roar. Effie trying to come in with the Slithering Crush to continue the stunning, and they will. So Asuna, Effie, and Zane combined for another kill on Zaturk. And an easy one at that. So Primal Roar, not the longest of cooldowns at a minute. So every minute, really, USS needs to watch out, because that is a killer combination. At this moment in time, could kind of take down anybody. Take a look over Legion. Kataru has spotted this Beastmaster. And as doing so, we'll push him out of the jungle. They did have two coming over for the back end flank, but pushing him out this early is going to make that gank impossible. So sentry placed by Zane. They will spot this enemy sentry. And they should be able to stack now with that Helm of the Dominator out on Meme Shard, who does pick himself up the tier 1 up top. So he's farming very well. We take it over to the net worth at 8 minutes in. He's got 4,300, leads by about 700, and they might be looking to go in on Alfredo. Look to chain stun once again. Alfredo might be in a little bit of trouble. He's going to have to use that blink to avoid the Stormhammer. Effie looking to come in, trying to bait out that blink, and will do so. And now Meme Shard will just farm away. So pretty easy. If he doesn't blink, he's dead. And if he blinks, he gives up farm. It's the pressure that Cupertino with this lineup can really make quite effective. So now they might be looking for a kill on both Conko and Alfredo. Coming around the back end is Nickel Pickle, not spotted by the tower just yet. Alfredo, Conko. They're close to tower. Meanwhile, mid, Zaturk goes down again, probably to that Primal Roar. Conko, he's way out of line. That's another easy kill. So we take a look. It is the Primal Roar that they used mid to get Zaturk. And blinking out is Alfredo. So they got the kill on Conko, an easy kill. Again, they can just line up these stuns with the purification. It's a lot of burst damage, and there's no answer from the side of University School Sharks. They really don't have much to answer with. Zaturk's dead. The only thing that could really stop that is a tornado and maybe a stun from the Ogre Magi chance, but without them there, that's easy pickings for Cupertino, who are now up 5-0. And they're already up 4,000 net worth. So Repel comes out on Meme Shard. He was cold snap. There's the Slithering Crush out on Alfredo. Trying to TP out is Nickel Pickle. The stun, mini stun comes in from Alfredo using his ulti on Nickel Pickle, who doesn't have enough mana for Dyer's mid tower could use a little help. His purification anymore, and he should be an easy target. And he will fall. And also falling is Zane, who fell mid. Not too sure how he fell. Who'd he fall to? Died to the Legion and the Invoker. Meanwhile, Effie goes down too, and three kills go the way of University School Sharks, so good rotations. Some good kills. And starting to crawl their way out of the big deficit that was 3,500.
The Dire best do something about that bottom tower.
So Zane, 2-1-2. Was that dual damage for the Legion commander? No. But now as that blink should get a little bit easier. We take a look over mid Effie. is around while Sven Memeshar does take this ancient stack. Puts himself at about 300 more gold, looking for the Echo Saber. Let me take a look over at this courier. He's almost got it. He's got some of it. Needs that Ogre Club, and he's about 600 gold away from it. Taking a look over, there's the Blink with the dual Sunstrike coming in. I'm not too sure it's going to be enough. There's the Global Silence. He can't zip away. And they do find another kill on Zane. It's the combination they've been looking for. But it took Duel, it took Global Silence. They just don't have the damage out on Legion yet. To really get that Duel damage, they need to have more there. And, you know, they do get the lockdown and they do get the kill on Storm Spirit. But it's not too much gained without the Duel damage. No, it's a kill. That's nice, but I need it to be a bit more. So here comes the TP's in. Sprint from Effie. He's going to get hit with that Curse of the Silent. Last words out on him, too. Purification heals him up. There's the Stormhammer coming out on Chance. Kitaro's around the corner. He is invis with that rune. They've got the Hawk Sunstrike off the money. Now here comes the Primal Roar out on Conkle. He's got no more mana because of that. Necro Creeps coming in as Zane. They're trying to get themselves a kill on Conkle. They'll finally find themselves the first kill. They've got the Stormhammer up top. Meanwhile, the Electric Vortex hits on Chance. He'll be the second to fall. Is it targeting him in a little bit of trouble? He's got that Amplified damage out on him. Two more shots should do it. And there's the press, the attack. That's going to purge him a little bit, get him a little bit more movement speed, and get him out of range of the side of Cupertino. So the press, the attack does enough for the Legion to get their Invoker out of there. They get themselves two supports, not the craziest deaths in the world, but again, Cupertino find themselves up 7-4 and putting that net worth back down towards 3,000. Echo Saber finally finished here for the Sven Meme Shard. Echo Saber, Helm and the Dominator, he's farming really well, almost at 100 last hits and about 400 net worth in front of this Animage. They're trying to make enough space for him, and he's 400 gold away from finishing off that Battle Fury, and that's really all they need. Meanwhile, Z-Turk finds another kill on Storm Spirit with Kitaro getting the duel off and finally finding himself 10 duel damage. So they're crawling their way out, USS. Trying to win this game 2, even the series up at 1. Trying to push this series to a game 3. As Animage, he's found himself some space and almost at this Battle Fury. Just about 30 gold away, and that is it. So he's got the Battle Fury. USS has made enough space for him to finally get that Battle Fury, and now this does put Cupertino in a little bit of trouble. The dual damage, the farming capability of Alfredo now might cause Cupertino to start being on their heels. So they've got the Legion with the duel. The Sunstrike will come out. Zane zipping in. They're trying to get Chance, trying to get him out of this TP. And they won't be able to do so. So Meme Shard, he's got himself four in that Great Cleave. Trying to find himself a bit more farm, but the question is, can he keep up with this Animage? Animage with the Battle Fury at about 13 minutes in really wasn't that bad, and he'll start to pick up now as he hasn't died once yet, and he is really looking to put himself atop of that net worth and make it so his team can be the ones who are the aggressors. And they are doing so with the duel and the Sunstrike. They just want to be more the aggressors, and they will be able to do just that with Alfredo finding himself a couple of items. Meanwhile, Lasuna off camera will find himself a kill. That's Primal Roar being used. No skills being used. Primal Roar is not used. They just find themselves a kill on Chance. So with that, all five will head over into Roche. And if USS spot this out, throw a Sunstrike over there. They do have it invoked. They just need to throw it, and they will spot it now. Not going to hit Roche, but they will see it. Amplified damage is there. Not too much they can really do about it, as three of them are up top. Alfredo's just going to farm away and not really care about this Aegis out on Zane, but they're looking for dual damage. They're coming in. Effie gets hit by that duel, and it is another duel win for Kitaro, who's now got 24 duel damage. So they've got themselves the time, they've got themselves the space, and Kotaro, he's going to start to snowball, starting to get that dual damage. It opens up space for Alfredo, who will continue to farm already at 1,400 gold after picking up that Battle Fury. And Kotaro just wants dual damage, and just wants to get that much stronger. Looking for that Blade Mail next. Take a look over at Zaturk. Has picked up that Midas at about 1,200 gold. We'll see if he goes for Ags next. Then for the side of Cupertino, 2,000 gold for this Sven. Probably saving up for a Blink Dagger. We take a look over at the Swordar. No Blink Dagger for him just yet. That's really what they need to initiate onto the side of University School Sharks. A little bit better. They do have Zane to come in with the Electric Vortex. But he needs to find himself that Bloodstone soon, so he can have enough mana regen and mana in general to really get the combination off. So they do spot that Zane's down low with this ward just for a split second. They all pinged it out. Now there's the Blink Dagger for Meme Shard. They might look to go in on Alfredo. There is the Warcry with the God's Strength and the Stormhammer disjointed. As Alfredo finds himself out, he's looking for a Vanguard with that Vitality Booster. We take a look down low. There's the Global Silence going to wear off. Zane trying to TP out? No, he'll just zip himself out. So Global Silence is used, but they don't find a kill for it. They go up top. There's the Stormhammer out on Alfredo. Meme Shard might be in a little bit of trouble, looking for that Blink to hit him. And they do miss the Sunstrike, but now they get the duel. They're going to have to put out a lot of damage to get the duel damage. Not going to be in time, but they still find themselves the kill. So no duel damage, but they do find another kill. That's Blade Mail finished for Kotaro. They can use that against the Sven. And it's going to make duels that much easier with the Sunstrike as well. And it's now 8-7. Cupertino in favor of kills, but back to even on the net worth. And with it back to even with a team that's trying to go late game, USS, they are in a pretty good spot right now. About 18 minutes in, and they're starting to find a power spike. Alfredo really needs to watch out. He's far forward. Meme Shard and Alfredo spot each other. There's the Blink into the trees. And he will be fine. And still, Effie, he is without this Blink Dagger. And I think it's something that they do desperately need. Effie can die. He can jump in. He can stun. He can be that sacrificial lamb. But for Sven to be the first one to blink in there, it's not something that's going to work out all too often. They don't want him in the front lines just yet. Or at least initiating just yet. They can with that Blink Dagger, but I feel like they'd be better off with Effie taking the death, getting the stuns, and maybe baiting out that Blink from Alfredo or grabbing himself the Slithering Crush on Alfredo, which could be followed up by a Stormhammer. So we take a look, here come the TPs, and now Nickel Pickle, he's going to be in a bit of trouble. There's the Global Silence trying to find themselves more dual damage, and they will, and it's now 38, but coming in now is Cupertino. They get the Primal Roar out on Zaturk. He's getting pretty low, and he will be the second to fall on the side of University School Sharks. Meme Shard coming in with that God's Strength, and now the Amplified Damage. This could be trouble. There's the Blade Mail, but 4 are here from Cupertino, and they take down the Legion too. They grab the tier 2, they grab 3 on the side of University School Sharks, and just like that, Cupertino take a pretty good fight despite losing the Omni Knight. They'll look to take this top tier 3 too, and that's their answer to letting this game go late. They need to push, push, push. Meme Shard TP is low, he's got 2600 gold saved up. Blink, Echo Saber, and Helm of the Dominator. See what he goes for next. Probably going to try and take this Ancient Camp. Nope. Just trying to stack it. And he will. And see the time. He's trying to stack it, and he does do so successfully. That's a bit more gold going his way. And he has bought an item on the courier, and it will be the first two components of a BKB. Wants to be able to get out of that Global Silence. Global Silence used, then BKB, and he will be able to now throw Storm Hammers when everybody else is silenced up. So the confidence that might come on USS after using Global Silence, it might be not well thought out after this BKB gets picked up by Meme Shard on that Sven. So Asuna, he might be in a little bit of trouble. He does drop down the Hawk. It will spot out Alfredo and Kitaru. 211 in favor of Cupertino. They've got themselves about a 1,500 gold lead. But they are still sitting on their heels, and now Necro 3 is picked up by the Beastmaster.
Dire's top tower, you know the drill.
So Bloodstone is there for Zane. Finally a Blink Dagger on this Slardar.
Dire's top tower.
And Zane now looking for the Orchid, and that's where he started to ball out last game.
Radiant's bottom tower seemed
better. This game he's 4-3-6, not as good of a game, but still pretty solid. So we take a look, Alfredo with the Vanguard and the Asha, probably going to go for the Manta style next, then finish off the Abyssal Blade. So Turk's still up top, he's got that Midas and Yules, but no Ags. He's sort of weak despite being in that 4 slot for net worth. Okay, meanwhile, off screen again, we miss another kill. Any mage will somehow fall, and it's not really telling me the abilities used. They definitely used Primal Roar, they definitely used God Strength, but the fight recap not giving me anything. So with that Kaelon Alfredo, they don't really want to buy back on him. And they will continue to push. There's the curse. With a blink and a slithering crush with Zane coming in on chance. Amplified damage is there. Still zipping forward. Zane with the repel. He should be okay. Not going to get stunned up. One more hit will bring down chance. And now can they turn it around on Zane? He does not have that Aegis. So he's just going to commit suicide. Minus two. Purification comes out on Effie. Lasuna might be in a little bit of trouble. Kitaru not going to blink forward and not going to try and get that dual damage as he gets hit by the boar. Oops. So we take a look at the fight recap. Again, just a one for one. Chance goes down and Storm Spirit suicides. Not telling us anything still. And Alfredo did not buy back. So he's going to continue to farm 219 last hits. We take a look. Zane moving forward, but they're not going to find anything on the side of USS. Maybe they look down low. They've got that ward. They're looking for Alfredo. Zane, if he comes in, gets the electric vortex, as well as the orchid. Doesn't have the orchid yet. If he did, it would be trouble for Alfredo. So Zaturk, what's he getting here? Boots travel, still no Ags or anything. They're trying to find themselves a kill on Lasuna, don't go in, but there's the Yules. Maybe they can find dual damage. Overwhelming odds with the duel, and they do get dual damage, but here is Zane trying to bring down a couple of his own. They do finally get the Invoker, they get the Ogre Magi, so Zaturk and Chance are dead, as well as Conkle. Kitaru with the blade mail pop, but amplified damage is there, and four fall on the side of USS, and they only lose the Beastmaster. Sven wasn't even there. So Animage is going to try and force them back. He's going to push this top tier 3. The buyback is there from the LC. Meme Shard is going to take that mid tier 3. I don't think this Animage can push faster than Meme Shard. Now the blink in the opposite direction. Effie looking for the blink. Slithering crush. Can he find it? He will. This is definitely going to have some bad implications for Alfredo. But oh boy, with that ulti, he gets a double kill. Alfredo makes the escape. He pops Zane as well as the Slardar and escapes with his life. Whew.
That's exact.
Wow. Visibility. So Alfredo makes it out alive, and not only out alive, finds two big kills. And now Meme Shard looking for that Stormhammer, somehow finds it after the blink. Doesn't technically get thrown till after. There's press the attack from Alfredo. Now they're trying to go in on Meme Shard, trying to turn it around. There's the BKB pop by Meme Shard. They still want to go in, but he will blink further away and TP out. So they don't want to go out too far. If they die again, that could be it. Especially Legion Commander, she bought back. So net worth 5,000 in favor of Cupertino once again. The dual damage is at 52 for Legion Commander. So in the Roche pit is Cupertino, and it doesn't look as though USS have spotted this, and they won't be there in time anyway if they try to go for it. They are under ward vision. Effie coming around the bend. They do have Aegis now on Zane. There's the Slithering Crush. Does hit on Chance. Here comes Zane. Lightning Ball in with the Electric Vortex. And Chance will die. So another easy kill for Cupertino. They do grab the Aegis as well. And the Animage, a big counter to Zane. If he's low on mana. And they do have that ulti up again for Alfredo. So, Cupertino, they really need to watch out. Alfredo, he gets spotted. But he is in base. They're pinging him out. They have the wards on the high ground. They're trying to find a kill on Alfredo. Without Alfredo, they're pretty safe in this high ground. They start to go in. Zane, he is regenning that mana quite quickly. There's the duel coming out on the spam with the Sunstrike. Can they do anything? But the Electric Vortex comes out from the Storm Spirit. They will bring down the Legion Commander with the Guardian Angel getting popped. The Roar comes out on Zitark. He's going to try and back himself up. Chance, meanwhile, he's going to try and find his escape. He backs up just enough. They've got the Aegis popped in. Now the spam comes in with the Stormhammer and the God Strength. There's the Multicast on the Fire Blast. They're still trying to find themselves some kills. Zipping forward onto Zitark is this Storm Spirit Zane, and they haven't found anything just yet. It's just a one for one for now. There's a Purification healing up Zane just a bit, but Meme Shard comes in with the God Strength. A couple more hits, he will fall, and now Alfredo trying to find something will die, and now he will immediately buy back. Cupertino, they need to watch out. They need to get out, as Meme Shard almost fell there, and that could definitely change this game. But Zane has full mana, and that's really where the issue lies for the side of University School Sharks. They're trying to zip their way out. And nobody will die on the back aim for Cupertino. So an alright fight there for Cupertino. They grab themselves half racks and they do force the buyback from Alfredo. So now University School Sharks, they need to extend this game even further. And that's going to be really tough with everything that Cupertino's throwing their way. They did get the Aegis out of the way. So the confidence is kind of held back from Cupertino. But they do pick themselves up the Orchid and the Daedalus on Storm Spirit and Sven respectively. The wards from Cupertino are very solid right now. And Zane comes in, but he's got no mana. He's in between the entire side of USS, but they are just not going in on him. If any mage gets boots of travel too, it could be trouble. You know, Zane could go in on someone, then they get the boots of travel too. They use the ulti from the any mage, but I doubt they're going to go in that direction. Meanwhile, Zane again gets that regen rune, that lucky green one, on the Storm Spirit. So backing up is the side of University School Sharks, and let's take a look at this buyback status. Only on Storm Beastmaster for the side of Cupertino. Meanwhile, the only one who's got it for University School Sharks is that silencer. So it could definitely become trouble if any of the cores on the side of University School Sharks fall. So maybe looking to make something happen is Cupertino. They're putting the pressure on to University School Sharks. Meanwhile, Alfredo, he's still stuck in base. Has himself that Vanguard with the Manta Battle Fury, but no Abyssal Blade just yet. As the side of Cupertino, they're starting to make their way into the base, pushing these creeps to the high ground and looking to take out that other half of the racks. This will be their first full set of racks. There's God's Strength, and now he will just destroy it immediately. They don't want to go in on this. They don't want to commit without the buybacks on the side of USS, especially with that God's Strength and Repel out on Meme Shard. They want the God's Strength to wear out. And it will wear out in just a moment as it's 3/4 done. They're losing their base. They're losing their towers. They're losing their racks. And they're losing it all. The Purification keeps him high up. There's Curse of the Silent. Lasuna moves forward looking for that Primal Roar. And they do the damage and they just all TP out. So, you know, they want to go in and they don't really find anything except a courier. Don't get anybody on the retreat. So with that Meme Shard, he's got himself that Daedalus BKB. Echo Saber Helm is out in the stash, and it's looking pretty bad for University School Sharks as they are now down 12,000 net worth. Again, this is an Animage game. Anything can happen. One good fight from an Animage, he'll push that tier 3 up top as well as the racks down, and that will definitely be trouble for Cupertino. Dire's bottom tower is getting the business. Both teams have pretty good wave cleaners. Coming down low is the side of Cupertino. They get the Storm Hammer out as well as the Orchid. Alfredo in trouble, and he is still alive for the moment. But Meme Shard grabs that last hit. He buys out with the Basher, and he's dead for 90 seconds. And with that kill, Cupertino might look to finish this game once and for all. They did ping, or it was actually USS who pinged out the tier 4s. But again, God's Strength will clean up this other half of the racks in one shot. And now Cupertino will take the base. They look towards tier 4s. No God Strength for 40 seconds. No Anti-Mage for 60 seconds. There's the Blink with the Slithering Crush. Coming in is Zane. They've got the Curse of the Silent with the Global Silence. And now Zyturk's going to back off into the base. Conkle's trying to find something. Meme Shard is hitting away a chance. And there is the duel. But Guardian Angel's going to keep him alive. There's the Electric Vortex with the Chaos Meteor coming down from Zyturk. But really not doing anything. That's 3 dead. That's 4 dead on the side of USS. No. Actually, Conkle is going to stay alive as Storm Spirit falls. So Chance trying to do something. Meme Shard will one-shot him. Meme Shard continuing to move forward. Zyturk, he's trying to take away Meme Shard, trying to kill him. He's got that repel, and now he's going to have to back off. But Lasuna is here with Meme Shard with the Storm Hammer, and Zyturk will fall. It's all on Conkle. Cupertino, they're looking to finish this game. They finally lose that Sven. He'll buy back. They're still going for tier 4s with the repel coming out from Nickel Pickle. 28 dual damage out on this Sven. They are looking to win this game, take this series, and stamp their ticket to that grand final. The Animage is back. He's going in on Lasuna. In comes Zane. He's going to look for that ult as he gets hit by that Electric Vortex. He's stunned up. He's in a little bit of trouble. Can't get that ult off as the Bash is hit. And GG is called. Cupertino will be going to the finals. They take this series 2-0 and eliminate the University School Sharks. So Cupertino advanced to the best of 5 final next weekend, while University School Sharks drop to the 3rd place game, which is only a best of 3. Cupertino take this series 2-0. We'll be back with more soon. Stay tuned, I am your caster, BCOP92, on Twitter, and on Twitch, twitch.tv/gamingforgelt. I'll see if we're coming back immediately. I'll tell you guys in chat, but we will be back soon. Thanks for watching.